So you want to be a wedding photographer, but you don't know the equipment to get started. In today's video, we're going to talk about a few principles to guide your purchase decisions, as well as talk about the equipment that I would use if I were starting over today. Speaking of starting, that needs to be your first goal as you design your kit. You just have to start somewhere. You should make your financial barrier to entry as low as possible so you can begin as quickly as possible. Realistically, it's not going to be your gear that limits your potential as you get going, but it'll be your limited experience and portfolio and skills. Prioritize shooting your first wedding as soon as possible. For best value, I recommend purchasing everything you can, either used or refurbished. One of the best places to check for used beginner gear is actually eBay, and that's because you can oftentimes find a couple core pieces like a camera body and lens, maybe the ones we'll talk about a little bit later, but you can oftentimes find them bundled together for a discounted price. Otherwise, you can't go wrong by shopping at a reputable large camera store like B&H or Adorama. Otherwise, other places like KEH, which is a designated used camera store, is also a fantastic option. Another option that I use personally quite a bit is to purchase refurbished directly through the camera manufacturer like Canon or Sony. You definitely want to keep your starting costs low, but you also want to have a clear, simple, smart, upgradable path down the road. Honestly, you're probably not going to be using your beginner camera and lenses long term. And when it's time to upgrade, it's better to improve one piece at a time instead of revamping your entire system. The gold standard for wedding photography is mirrorless cameras and lenses, so that's what I would recommend investing in as you get started. With everything in mind so far, let's talk about the beginner wedding photography equipment that I would purchase if I was starting over today. For cameras and lenses, I'd recommend investing in either Canon RF mount or Sony FE mount for most photographers. I'll make a separate video talking about which camera system is right for you, but for today, we're just going to list off my recommendations for beginners, as well as include links to all of those in the description. If you decide to go with the Canon system, which is what I personally use, I would recommend purchasing two Canon EOS Rs, and I would upgrade one of those to an R6 if funds allow. Otherwise, you can always upgrade that down the road whenever possible. Your main lens should be a Canon RF 35mm 1.8. So the 35mm lens is a fantastic option, and you can use this to shoot an entire wedding if you have to. I remember when I first started, this was my go-to lens. The other lens you're going to want to get is the Canon RF 50mm 1.8. Now, this is also a great lens, but it's not as nice as the 35, so that's the one you're going to want to use as your main lens. But this is a fantastic backup, or if you need a little bit more reach than the 35mm allows. So the concept of prime lenses, or lenses that don't zoom, compared to zoom lenses, which are lenses that do, is a complete video by itself, which we'll do down the road. But I would say that budget prime lenses are better than budget zoom lenses, even though I personally prefer zoom lenses today. When your budget allows, I would recommend immediately purchasing the Canon RF 24-70 f2.8. Now, your camera should come with their own batteries already, but I would purchase two additional backup batteries as well. Now, I would recommend going Canon brand specifically and buying them new. So this is actually the only case where I'd recommend going new would be for batteries, because they tend to last longer and be more reliable. For memory cards, I would recommend getting three SanDisk Extreme Pro 128GB UHS-I memory cards. So that is one for each camera body as well as one backup. You're going to need a way to carry all of your equipment, and I would personally purchase a used Peak Design backpack. Lastly, for your camera strap, I would purchase a used Peak Design slide. Everything we've listed so far is actually what I would say is the minimum to shoot intimate outdoor weddings. Looking online and buying refurbished cameras and lenses directly through Canon, as well as purchasing used camera backpacks and straps, you could purchase this whole setup for about $3,650. If you don't want to use the Canon system, but you want to go the Sony route instead, I would recommend purchasing two used Sony A7 Mark IIIs. And as before, I'd upgrade one of those to the Mark IV if your funds allow. Otherwise, you can always upgrade that down the road as well. Other than that, the setup I would recommend is basically the same as the Canon side. So I'd start with a 35mm 1.8 as your main lens, with the 50mm 1.8 as your backup. From there, I'd recommend purchasing the Sony FE 24-70 f2.8 Mark II whenever possible. You'll want two backup Sony batteries as well. And for the memory cards, I would actually recommend going with four of them instead of three because the Sony cameras have dual card slots. Pair it all together with the same backpack and strap as before, and now you have the minimum needed to photograph intimate outdoor weddings. For this setup, I would recommend purchasing as much used equipment through KEH as you possibly can, and you actually get 5% off your first purchase through them as well. And with that in mind, I can get this entire setup for about $4,050. Technically, you just need a camera, lens, and memory cards to photograph a wedding, and realistically, if you're shooting only weddings that are outdoors during the day, that's all you really need. However, if you have indoor receptions, you're gonna need at least a little bit of lighting equipment. For that, I would recommend a Flashpoint Zoom Roundhead Speedlight. Now, there are a lot of budget options out there that are really great as well. However, the cost of a budget level flash system and a pro level flash system that you don't have to upgrade later are actually really close together. So I recommend just investing in a quality system right away. One other note is that Flashpoint is actually the same company as Godox, but Flashpoint is just sold exclusively from Adorama and it has a USA warranty. So if you're in the United States, you're gonna wanna go with the Flashpoint options instead of the Godox. You're gonna want some diffusion to make your flash look a little bit nicer, and I would recommend going with the Magmod Flash Starter Kit 2. You really can do everything you need with just a single flash, but if your budget allows, I would recommend getting a second one either as a backup or you can use that for some off-camera flash work. And then you would also need a stand and maybe a couple other accessories. And there you have it. That is all the equipment that I would recommend for a beginning wedding photographer. If you have time, check out the other video I made talking about the wedding photography equipment that I currently use in my sixth year. Otherwise, I hope you learned something today and thanks for watching.